So I just got out of the water. Today was supposed to be an easy, relaxing day with friends, but we actually found a lot of really cool Miocene and Ice Age fossils. So we're gonna show you what we saw underwater, some of the cool fossils that we managed to find, and hopefully you guys enjoy it. Oh, they're getting in the good stuff? I'm getting in the good stuff. Look at this sloth tooth. I'll have to get the better camera out. That is amazing. We are out of the water after the first 10 minutes of diving, and it was not a bad start at all. We've got a gator jaw with some empty sockets that'll be cool to restore, giant armadillo scoot, part of their defensive armor, some horse teeth, and then this. That thing is amazing. That is a perfect ground sloth tooth, a giant ground sloth. This thing would have been 10 feet tall at the shoulders. They don't actually have enamel like other mammals do. They have these weird like rib-shaped teeth, but that's amazing. I'll show a picture of what the jaw that this came from looks like and what this animal looked like. And they were impressive browsers here in the Ice Age. But that's not gonna be the best thing we find today, hopefully. So I'm gonna get back underwater and try to find more. So I wasn't actually sure what this bone here was. I thought it might be a sloth bone, but it's actually the last toe bone to a mammoth or mastodon foot. I don't have a lot of these. I'll put on the screen what these animals' feet look like, but that's a really rare find. I got another toe bone.
What did you think it was?
Sitting right over there. I couldn't tell if it was sloth or tapir underwater.
I thought it was sloth or tapir.
Yeah, that's definitely last mammoth toe bone. And that's definitely a fossil hunter.
I haven't done much of that today.
That's a trip maker. That's a trip maker. For sure.
Yeah. 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 This is a good one.
Joe found some decent stuff just walking on the bank, though.
Tooth,
some Bone Valley
big gator
colors.
Tooth. Little llama tooth.
That's nice.
Little pretty green tooth.
Lots of shark teeth, man. We're gonna find some more stuff today.
Yeah, probably.
I'm gonna eat some lunch, though. I'm starving. A little known fact about geologists is that we actually like to forage for rocks and their sustenance. So we can get one of these bad boys and we can just... It's so good. It's not good for your teeth over a long period of time. The geologists actually got 4 sets of teeth for this purpose. And they're pretty delicious. You want one, Joe?
What in the hell? Yeah, sure.
Ah! Ah! Oh, that tooth! What the shit? Not a geologist.
That's another toe bone.
Yeah, an ankle bone or something.
Yeah, I got two different toe bones to mammoth or mastodon. That one, and then that final digit we were looking at.
A half a plastron?
Yeah, I was kind of sad. That
that's
was
nice.
Buried
yeah.
The,
it's got the hinge
sand.
To it.
Lots of little shark teeth, which, you know, you and I don't care as much about.
Yeah, just...
Where's that giant armadillo's skewer? Is it back here?
There
it
no
is.
Idea.
That,
you had it last.
Like, that's the sandwich I was eating. That is the largest piece of giant armadillo armor I have ever found. That would have been a big boy or girl.
Big boy. Oh,
cool,
a little bison?
Oh, yeah, a little bison tooth.
Is that bison or llama?
I didn't take a good enough look, but it's got a bison shape to it. Not a llama
it
shape.
It does, but it doesn't have the little
Yeah, but it's
cuspid.
A premolar, so I'm pretty sure that's bison.
Yeah, cat found what looks like a little bison premolar.
And then look at that porpoise vertebrae. Really good shape. Cool mixture of ice age and marine fossils here.
Mm-hmm.
Really quality tooth for this area. You gonna get suited up?
Yeah, I just ate, so I'm gonna give my food a chance to settle.
Every single week, this seems like this gets to be the harder and harder part of fossil hunting with Joe is getting his wetsuit up.
You're hamming it up, buddy.
I'm gonna have to put you guys on standby while I fix Joe's wetsuit.
Getting too big for my britches.
Yeah, you are.
So I just got this piece of mammoth tooth, and Joe found something weird. What is that?
No idea what that is.
Let me take a look at that. Let me see.
What the hell's that?
That's weird. I think it's a foot bone or something.
That's what it looks like.
But it's so solid.
Like, yeah.
Here you go.
Doesn't look right at all.
That's a weird find.
Yeah.
Big old whale vertebrae right here. Look at that. Big old whale vertebrae. Dude, I just found a partial gonfalon here too.
Huh?
Partial gonfalon here too.
Bullshit.
Come here. That's the biggest gonfalon toothpiece I have ever found.
Oh yeah. That's definitely
That's gonf. That's gonfalon.
Yeah.
That is crazy. That is one of the weirdest extinct animals we have in Florida. They had shovel tusks. They are in their own genus, the Roy Mastodons, Mammoths, Elephants, and they are weird animals. And that is just a piece of one of their teeth. Oh, I'm so mad that's not whole. I would have freaked out absolutely. Wow. That is crazy.
That thing has got to be one of the rarest things I've found in this river. All the mastodon teeth I've seen, and that's the first chunk of a gomphothere I've ever found. That would have been... big. How big do you think that would have been? Out to there?
Last hump, probably like yay tall.
Oh man, it's so sad that it's just a partial, but I'm very happy with that. That's 8 million years old. Much older than some of this Ice Age stuff we've been finding, like the mammoth and mastodon material. And then that gomphoth there. It's been a really good day so far. We're going to do a bit of fanning to end today, but I'm already pretty happy with how it's going. Right now, we're going to take a break, huh?
John don't know how lucky he is to have found just this, because if he had found 3, 4, 5, all the whole thing, we would have had an accident going back to the boat.
Oh, no, I don't want to be in an accident.
I need an accident go back to the boat.
I really don't want to be in no accident.
Every single video I joke about accidentally on purpose killing you, and one day if you ever get badly injured, people are going to think I finally snapped.
So Joe's actually got our first interesting find fanning. He found a horse tooth before this, but that is a really nice extinct whale tooth. Cool shape to it. That's from a sperm whale. It's an extinct sperm whale. There's 12 genuses of them. Only 2 are around anymore. There's 14 genuses, 12 extinct ones. 2 are still around. So that's a really cool... I know the math, right? They only have these teeth in the lower jaw, which makes them kind of... unique, but you don't find them that often. And that's a good find.
Well, they're a little bit more common than gomphothere teeth.
Boop! Find some more stuff.
That's a cool tooth. It's got perfect roots. Oh yeah. Same species. And it's perfect. 100% there. Okay. I think it's wicked.
After I handed this off to Kat, I did not get another chance to record it, so I wanted to show it to you before we get back into the river. This is by far the nicest sperm whale tooth, extinct sperm whale tooth, I have ever found. It's literally perfect. It's got the cavity right there. These patterns right here, the smooth parts are from feeding damage, feeding wear, and it's big. This would have been a big, big whale. So we did do a little bit more fanning after the whale tooth, but unfortunately that was the best thing besides one horse tooth that we found doing that. We're about puckered out and we're gonna go head home, get some dinner.
Tuckered out.
No, I think that's fine.
No, it's fine.
Yeah, it's fine. It's fine.
Viewers like to know he's human.
Yeah. I mean, we're all humans. You just see me through a screen right now.
That sounds alien.
I'm definitely a human. I'm not a lizard person or an alien. But if you guys enjoyed today's video, make sure to like, share,
if John makes it to 100K, lizard person confirmed, because only lizard people can get that platinum
badge. It's true. And as always, keep on digging science.